Hey everybody, Jochen here, and today I'm going to show you how to separate your incoming communications as well as your own outgoing communications into a separate track when you record anything with Shadowplay using the new separate both tracks feature that you can see in the video that I just linked above. Now, to be able to do this, you will need a software application called Voicemeeter Banana. And in order to get to it, you can easily just go to their main site, VB Audio. Now, if you don't know what it is, Voicemeeter allows you to set your inputs, multiple inputs, and have it separated between channels. Have your system sound in one section, your incoming communications in another section, and then have multiple outgoing channels as well. So multiple outgoing speakers or cables or whatever. Now, we'll be using this software, so what you want to do is go to vbaudio.com and just click on the banana, Voicemeeter banana icon. As soon as you click on that, simply just keep on scrolling down until you get to this image. Once this image is there, scroll down a little bit further and you can click on download. The download file will have an exe inside it, just simply run it. It is donationware, please support these guys. This is an absolute fantastic piece of software that I simply cannot go without anymore, especially when you're doing any kind of streaming or recording. Now, once you've downloaded everything, simply just scroll back up to the top and click on Virtual Audio Cable. And then as soon as you click on this image, you'll jump down to VB Audio Virtual Cable. Now, this cable is an additional input and output. Again, it is free. Again, it is donationware. So if you do find this useful, just say thanks to the guys and support them any way you can. Now, once you've installed the Voicemeeter Banana as well as the VB cable, you will see the following items in your recording. So there's the VB cable, Voicemeeter auxiliary, and Voicemeeter auxiliary output, as well as in playback. I've renamed it to VB Audio Speakers, and then I've renamed it to VM Comms, Voicemeeter Comms, and Voicemeeter Desktop, just to make things a little bit easier. You'll see the VIO and the auxiliary VIO when we look at Voicemeeter itself. That is the VIO and the auxiliary VIO. That's why I renamed it to Comms and Desktop. And I've done it here as well, just simply right-click over there, give it any name you want, and then as well as the Desktop. So, now with everything installed, it is fairly easy to get your setup to record into both your comms and your mic over here to go into separate channels. So, first of all, let's just set this up. Just click on the name over there, select your microphone, right-click at the top there, enter a name for it. If you've got a secondary microphone that you use, select it over here, and again, just right-click and name it whatever you want up there. Now, there is one more thing to note. In your TeamSpeak or Skype or Discord, in my case, simply go down to your settings, go to voice, and then as a output device, select the Voicemeeter comms channel. So in my case, it's the Voicemeeter auxiliary VIO. And that will mean that any kind of incoming communications will go into this channel over here. You also want to make sure that the VIO channel for Voicemeeter is set to default for your desktop settings, which will then mean that all your sound settings will come into this channel over here. Now, one thing you'll note over here, my primary microphone is the Blue Yeti. I'm going to click on A3. What that'll do is it'll send it to this output channel. Now, the same thing for the communications coming in. I will put on A3, and that'll go to this. And this A3, I will send to the VB Audio Speakers. So that's this playback VB Audio Speakers. That's the virtual cable we downloaded. Now, I'm doing that over there. Now, the other tricky bit, go to recording, and then under the VB cable output mic, which I renamed it to, you'll see if you go to properties, click on listen, and then you say, let this device listen to my VB Audio Speakers device. So that means that anything that gets output into channel A3 will go to a virtual microphone. And what we can then do is when you go to your GeForce Experience and you go to your mic settings, you can then use your VB cable output mic as a selected income. Now what that means, it will see both your Blue Yeti and your communications merged together, and it'll have that track as the separate track and your game or your system sounds as the other track without having any incoming communications mutate your system sounds. Press the like down below, subscribe to my channel if you want to see more guides like this or any kind of game reviews or guides. Thank you for watching. Yoken out.